Are you cut out to be a hermit? Just you, nature, and the joy of your own company? Most of us are not. Instead, we live with others, often in dense, loud places called cities. We all know cities, but when was the last time you stopped to ask, how did the city that I know best come to be? How are cities around the world shaped? Or what is the future of cities? Today, we'll show you how cities are a technology that is evolving fast into smart cities and what this means for you.
Long before humans built smartphones or automobiles, we built cities. And this ancient technology remains a central driver of human progress today. Now, with population growth, pollution, natural disasters, and other challenges on the rise, how can we leverage the smart functions of cities where science, technology, and policy converge to create a sustainable future? Let's find out.
The earliest cities emerged thousands of years ago, enabled by key technological innovations such as irrigation and plowing. These advances allowed agricultural villages to produce surplus food, freeing some members of society from farming duties. As a result, specialized roles such as craftsmen, administrators, and traders began to develop.
To support these new roles, physical infrastructure like roads, administrative buildings, and power systems were constructed, often concentrated in a defined area, with a boundary and organized systems of governments to manage this complex social and economic activity, the city was born.
Over time, cities have emerged across the globe as unique artifacts of their geographic and historical context. Each reflects the technologies and needs of its era. Medieval cities were often compact and enclosed by defensive walls, shaped by necessity of protection and limited mobility. In contrast, 20th century cities often expanded outward, structured around the automobile, resulting in widespread suburban sprawl.
In 2025, more than 4 billion people live in cities. By 2050, nearly 70% of world population will reside in urban area. That's why many cities today are becoming smart, using technologies like AI, robotics, and digital twins to improve everyday life in a complex adaptive system. But being smart isn't just about having the latest technology. It's about choosing the right tools to meet people's needs, making cities safer, more efficient, and more sustainable, and better place to live.
Urban thinker Jane Jacobs challenged the top-down planning in her time, which often served those in power, arguing that cities should be built for everybody who lives in them. So, who is everybody? Cities are a dynamic ecosystem of residents, visitors, businesses, universities, government agencies, and nonprofits, and that mix looks different in every city around the world. The policies that shape cities look different too.
Located at the base of Mount Fuji, Toyota's Woven City in Japan is a living laboratory for the future society, redefining urban life with a focus on mobility. This experimental city features separate roads for self-driving vehicles, personal devices, and pedestrians. AI-powered homes with robotics help daily life, and hydrogen fuel cell power the city. Woven City is a practical demonstration of Japan's Society 5.0 policy, showing how advanced technology improves our daily life and well-being.
Masdar City in the UAE is a smart city built on the edge of the Arabian Desert. It's designed to reimagine how economic, social, and environmental sustainability converge. Although cities cover just 2-3% of land, they use over 75% of the world's natural resources. Masdar tests innovative ideas like driverless electric pods, smart utilities, and drone-based infrastructure monitoring to reduce environmental impact. The city brings together researchers, startups, and global companies from around the world to develop the next generation of clean technologies in a thriving urban community.
But smart cities aren't always built from the ground up. Many existing cities are being redesigned and upgraded with smart infrastructure. Want a less crowded ride on the Taipei MRT? Their smart system uses sensors, Internet of Things, and artificial intelligence to show you exactly how full each train car is in real time. This network transit display system helps you pick up a less crowded car, making your journey more comfortable.
Smart cities run on data, but that comes with a challenge: cybersecurity.
The cyber technologies are being layered on top of legacy physical infrastructure of the past, creating all sorts of new capabilities, but also creating new vulnerabilities that are exposing infrastructure to things like ransomware attacks, as well as cyber attacks.
This requires proactive risk assessment and mitigation strategies.
Smart cities can also tackle social equity. Science fiction often shows that technology can either make inequity worse or help fix it, serving as both warning and a reason to hope. In the movie Elysium, the rich live in a high-tech paradise above Earth, while everyone else faces hardship below.
Whereas the Golden City of Wakanda envisions a people-first design where inclusive technology, innovation, and science go hand in hand. Anchored by institutions like Wakanda University that empower citizens through education and civic engagement. In the real world, universities are a key part of city success.
I would say university innovation has given us access to information about the city, which is unprecedented. And if you can understand the trend lines of a place, you have no reason for not acting upon that, maybe making course corrections to things that you think are headed in the wrong direction, or improving upon what's working.
Think about that. What would a major smart city be without a university? Universities are powerhouses of economic development, educating and training the talent that powers tomorrow's jobs. The critical science behind nearly all modern technology begins in universities, and these discoveries often become the foundation for what smart cities put into action. And anyone can get involved in the action to make the city better, including you.
We are not just building cities. We're co-creating future for a good Anthropocene, a sustainable, resilient world shaped by humans. Smart technologies designed in collaboration with communities are set to change urban living into a seamless, sustainable, and deeply human experience. Together, let's transform future urban living.